रेडी स्टार्ट। मिस्टर वाइस चेयरमैन, नोइंग द ऑनेवर मूवर ऑफ दिस रिजोल्यूशन टू बी ए गुड पार्लियामेंटेरियन, आई हैड एक्सपेक्टेड दैट ही वुड प्लेस बिफोर द हाउस ऑल साइड्स ऑफ दिस प्रॉब्लम, आई हैड expected that he would be no less interested in the efficiency and discipline of the administration, no less interested in the public welfare than in the interest of the civil services. But I am sorry to observe that he has taken only one view of the matter, namely the interest of the civil services alone. He has not at all dwelt upon the frightful consequences which a strike of the sort we had the misfortune to have would have had on the country and the people in general. He has spoken, no doubt, in measured tones, unlike the honorable member who sat to his right in the morning and who raised a shout wanting to make up by sound what his arguments lacked in force. I wish to submit to this House that it would be incorrect and it would be imprudent for this House to accept this resolution. It would be incorrect because by accepting this resolution we would be laying down something bad in principle, and we would also be accepting a policy which would be suicidal and which could cut at the roots of discipline in the services. To the merits of reinstatement or otherwise of these persons I will come later on. I doubt the very propriety of Parliament going into this matter. Now let us see what has happened. Whether right or wrong, departments have taken up the question of these strikers. Those who took part in this strike, those who indulged in disobeying the ordinance, several cases of sabotage and intimidation, including criminal ones, have been going into, and the authorities have taken some decision. In some cases the government have taken the decision, and in some cases the departments have taken the decision. Now would it be right for Parliament to intervene, to interfere with these decisions? Suppose Parliament interfered with the decisions taken by the government or by the heads of departments tomorrow, with what face and with what authority can the head of a department extract service from his subordinates? This is the question which the honorable the mover must see, and also the other honorable members who have spoken in support of the resolution. Unemployment is mounting up and we have not been able to generate enough employment opportunities to provide even for those people who are entering the labor market today, perhaps to the extent envisaged during the third plan. The point that I want to make is that it is not quite justifiable to take only one aspect of the third plan period, namely the exigencies of capital mobilization, out of the context of the general economic situation in the country. When we are taking this huge tax effort, we will have to apply our mind with equal seriousness, if not more, to see that the income generation in the community is as great as is envisaged, so that the savings and investments could be effected without disturbing unnecessarily the consumption pattern in the community. Whenever there is any tax on corporations, this cry is raised, and this cry is always belied by what the industrialists themselves have claimed to be the sensitive barometer to find out the climate for capital formation. I mean the stock exchanges. This time the stock exchanges have reacted quite favorably to the budget proposals as a whole, which clearly shows that whatever else may be the merit of the present budget proposals, it is certainly not anti-capital. Last year also, the stock markets boomed up after the taxation proposals were announced. This time, though, they were a little hesitant at first. Ultimately, I think they have realized that there is nothing wrong with the taxation proposals, and they are now merrily mounting up. This is quite natural because there are so many benefits and advantages in our economy today that it is not difficult for the corporate sector to absorb a small rise of 5% in the corporation tax, which has been proposed by the Honorable Finance Minister. The economy of the nation today is more or less a closed economy because, due to the lack of external finances, imports have been virtually prohibited. There is a lot of planning in the country, which makes risk wearing rather unlikely, and because of the regulation of the economy, internal competition is also not very great. The risk wearing capacity, which is claimed by the industrialists, really forgetting large profits and large yields on their investment, is almost non-existent in our economy today. Our markets are expanding very fast, and the money generated is much more than the production of commodities, with the result that there are shortages is almost every commodity. It should not be difficult for the industrialists to absorb the small rise of 5% in the corporate tax stop.